This is NewsOK TV.
This is NewsOK TV. Welcome to NewsOK TV. It is Thursday, August 18th. We are quickly running out of days that are considered summertime days.
Yes, but it is still hot out there.
Alongside Angie Bruss, I'm Dave Morris. Here are a few of the headlines making news today, and of course, stories and videos you can find on newsok.com. State School Superintendent Janet Barresi is concerned about Oklahoma's recent ACT scores.
Barresi says the state must work harder to ensure its students are proficient in math and science when they graduate high school. The latest exam scores showed only 35% of our state's students met the math benchmark. In addition, only 25% met the science criteria. The national averages for both subjects are about 40%.
FEMA is recommending new homes in Oklahoma be built to withstand stronger wind gusts. Right now, houses are built to withstand 3-second wind gusts up to 90 miles an hour. However, a FEMA specialist recommends upgrading the requirement. An agency analyst says new homes should be able to hold up against 3-second wind gusts up to 120 miles an hour. The recommendations came after the deadly May 24th tornadoes that destroyed 600 homes and businesses in 6 counties and left 10 people dead.
A heat advisory is in effect for central and western Oklahoma. Friday's highs could reach 106 degrees. The weekend will be slightly cooler with highs in the low 100s.
OG&E is bringing its smart grid program to Midwest City and Dell City. These smart meters allow customers to manage energy costs by accessing a personalized energy information site. This site lets customers monitor their electricity use and the associated costs.
Sunbeam Family Services hopes to purchase an abandoned state-owned building. The agency was the highest bidder Wednesday in the auction of the Klassen Terrace office. The property has been vacant since the mid-90s. Sunbeam would like to tear down the current structure and build a new facility on the property. The organization hopes to consolidate under one roof. As of Thursday, Sunbeam had not heard if they'd won the bid. A new report states Oklahoma's manufacturing sector could bring 300,000 new jobs over the next 20 years. The report was released by an affiliate of the State Chamber of Oklahoma. Experts say manufacturing has seen the biggest employment increase in the past year.
OU officials haven't announced whether defensive end Ronnell Lewis will be eligible for the upcoming football season. Lewis had to pass his summer classes to suit up for the gridiron. If the junior is not able to play, David King moves into the starting lineup. Greyson Chance will perform a homecoming concert Friday night right up the road at Frontier City. Chance released his first album, Hold On Till the Night, just a few weeks ago. The Edmond Natives album entered number 2 on iTunes Pop Chart.
A local brewer's ale could soon be available on store shelves. Coop Ale says several distributors have picked up the Belgium-style ale called DNR. The beer company reports it will have 1,800 bottles available.
You know, one of the blogs that you can find on newsok.com is the Thirsty Beagle, which Nick Trigakis writes.
Nice.
Basically, it takes a look at beer and a lot of the local beers, and there are a lot of really great breweries and brewers in the state of Oklahoma.
I know. It's very neat.
We have an upcoming BCS, if you will, Beer Championship Series coming this fall. It'll be sponsored by our friends down at Tapworks. Be sure to check that out on the Thirsty Beagle blog.
Wow. Very cool. Very cool. And then switching gears. That's so great for Greyson Chance.
Oh yeah, good for him.
He's doing great. I can't believe his album was so high on iTunes.
And you know, this is great for you since you have that season pass to Frontier City.
Yes, exactly. No, that's awesome. I mean, he's like, what, 13, 14? Good for him.
He's doing things. Good
I know.
For him.
He is.
All right, now all these stories, of course, can be found on newsok.com, and many of them have video accompanying them because that's what we do around here. Be sure to stay with NewsOK to follow the stock market today. Got off to a rough start, starting to bounce back. We'll see how that lands. And for NewsOK TV for today, I'm Dave Morris.
And I'm Angie Bruss. Have a great one.